Brazilian police raid the home of former President Jair Bolsonaro and arrest two aides as part of an investigation into falsified COVID-19 vaccination records. Bolsonaro, a coronavirus skeptic who had vowed never to get the vaccine, was registered as vaccinated in health records made public in February. Police have allegedly found evidence Bolsonaro's vaccination status was falsified in his last weeks as president in late December, before he flew to the U.S., where most foreign visitors must be vaccinated. Bolsonaro has reiterated he has not taken the vaccine, but denies any role in the forging of documents. At least 21 are dead and 48 injured after Russia's latest airstrikes in the southern Ukrainian region of Kherson. On Telegram, Zelensky shared that Wednesday's shelling targeted civilian heavy areas such as a railway station, supermarket, and gas station. Moscow has denied deliberately targeting civilians, but many people have been killed in attacks on residential areas across Ukraine since the invasion in February last year. Russia's recent wave of attacks comes ahead of a Ukrainian counteroffensive to reclaim territory in the east. The United States gearing up to send Ukraine nearly $300 million in additional military aid. That's ahead of the latter's planned spring counteroffensive. The White House made the announcement Tuesday, where they shared that they would also be delivering artillery rounds, air-to-ground rockets, and howitzers.
This is the 37th package of security assistance for Ukraine using presidential drawdown authorities, and it follows extensive work by the U.S. government over the past few months to fulfill Ukraine's request ahead of its planned counteroffensive and ensure they have the weapons and equipment they need. We will continue to work with our allies and partners around the world to support Ukraine as they defend their democracy.
The European Union has also announced further plans to provide Ukraine with more ammunition. The EU's Internal Market Commissioner hopes to fund an act in support of ammunition production, which will provide Ukraine with much-needed rounds while replenishing the stocks of member states. A former U.S. Coast Guardsman accused of killing one person and wounding four in Atlanta has been arrested. Police say Deion Patterson was taken into custody without incident after an undercover officer spotted him north of the city in suburban Cobb County hours after the noontime shooting at a medical building. Patterson reportedly opened fire inside a waiting room of the Northside Medical Facility Wednesday before carjacking a vehicle to flee the scene.
Right now, we've had a successful end to a traumatic day. And today is a day that we can go home and rest easy, that the individual that caused harm in our community is under arrest thanks to this great partnership with Cobb County, Fulton County, City of Atlanta, Georgia State Patrol, and all of these great partners. So I hope that the city, the region, rests easy, that he's in custody. But I also hope that we stay vigilant to continue to look at a future where individuals that shouldn't have a gun in possession won't have one.
Iran seizes another oil tanker in Gulf waters, the second such incident in a week. The U.S. State Department said the Panama-flagged oil tanker Niovi was captured by Iran's Islamic Revolutionary Guard Corps Navy while the vessel was passing through the Strait of Hormuz. An Iranian prosecutor said the tanker was seized on a judicial order following a complaint. No further details were provided. The Strait of Hormuz is one of the world's most important oil shipping lanes, with roughly a third of all seaborne crude cargo having to navigate the narrow waterway. On Thursday, Iran seized a U.S.-bound oil tanker in the Gulf of Oman after the ship supposedly collided with an Iranian boat, leaving two people missing.